Okay, well, I guess some folks are here, so I guess we can go ahead and get started. First order of business, I'm very excited. I have a new coffee cup today. It's not new. I've had this coffee cup for many years, but it's a different one. So this was a crew gift back when I was working at Pixar. My first, I think my second movie up, they gave crew gifts to everyone, and this was mine. It was We all just did like Photoshop battles all throughout like the movie while we were working on it. And so for crew gifts, Gary, our lead, made like Photoshops of everyone and put them on coffee cups. So this is me like superimposed over some like famous painting of like Superman on a couch. So this is my my coffee cup for today. It's very exciting. So yeah, today will be actually a little bit short, probably because it's in the U.S. here. It's Thanksgiving this Thursday, so my girlfriend and I will be hopping on a plane in a few hours to fly to Chicago, where my brother is. So I may have to speed, not speed through, but maybe have to cut short a little bit. But thank you. I'm very happy for this cup. I have a small demo today, so. Just kind of, I'll give like a status update, and then we can jump to questions after that. But just wanted to mention, I know last week I had like the early Google Play version to show that had like the V2 logins on Google Play, where you can just use your Google Play login and it'll give you all the V2 features. And so I've been continuing basically to work on that and things related to that. There's some like server stuff I had to fix and just making it work as cleanly as possible. Also, I wanted to mention like this. So I forgot who was it who mentioned, let's see, where was it? Yeah, SCRCPY, this little cool app which lets you basically stream Android. So like I have my old Android test phone, which is like a Nexus 6, which is getting kind of old at this point. I probably should be testing on newer Android devices, but yeah, this little app is super cool for just if it's plugged in with a USB cable, I can stream the phone and like control the phone with through my computer and stuff like that. So super awesome for testing. So thank you. Why is my dock showing up? There we go. So anyway, just to kind of show you what I've been working on is kind of I was hoping to have a new Google Play test build out today, but I was running into enough issues that I want to get them all smoothed over before I put another test build up. So basically, this is kind of the screen I've been staring at. So here I have my little terminal where I'm just like rebuilding the Android version. So make. So if any of you are working with like the open source, like the make files and stuff, some of this might look sort of familiar. It's basically just some like extra make file stuff. Android platform Google, Android mode prod, Android asset scripts, make Android. Now here it will. Here it's going in and talking to all the Android stuff, building the game, installing the game on my Nexus 6. And in a moment, it should pop up. Okay, so this is a debug build of the game, and it's kind of an older phone, so it takes it a moment. I find it's actually kind of interesting to like try to work on older phones and older hardware sometimes because it really shows problems. Like if there's a part of the game that hitches a little bit, like it'll really hitch on like the slow old hardware. Okay, so here it is running on the phone, so you can see a little old Android phone here. So one thing in particular that hopefully this is somewhat interesting that I've been kind of sort of not stuck on but trying to fix is making the game like do the right thing when you whoops when you switch away from it. So when you come out and go to the home screen, it might seem like probably nothing has to happen, but actually like apps have to do a lot when you switch away from them. They have to kind of like shut themselves down and like close their network connections and put themselves into a state where like they're basically not using the processor at all. Because it's kind of interesting on getting on tangents here. If you're programming on Android, if you're using what's called the NDK, which is like the low-level way to code stuff, which is mostly what games and things use, there's nothing stopping your game or your app or whatever from like continuing to run in the background. So if you're not careful, you'll have a situation where, you know, if you put your game in the background, like when I was first writing Bomb Squad, I found I'd come in and go to the home screen, and then you'd still hear the music playing because it's like most of the stuff is just like still running in the background. So, which is different from, I know I haven't officially released an iPhone version yet, but I will at some point. And coding on iPhone, when your app goes into the background on iPhone, it basically, the OS just like stops everything. It like stops all your threads and closes all your network connections. And like, it just like, it doesn't like shut your app down, but it just completely, it's very forceful. So it's kind of interesting. We're on, you know, it's more flexible on Android, but it's also like, you gotta be careful so you're not, you know, wasting CPU in the background and stuff like that. Which leads me to the one bug that I was working on, is like, it turned out there's been a bug in the game for probably years now, where in some cases it would actually, like when you put it into the background, if a certain thread sent another message to the main thread, or the logic thread it's called, like the game would sit there and like go into like a loop and it would spin and like burn CPU and stuff. So I was super surprised when I found that yesterday after trying to like debug this thing. So it's funny how that is, like, you know, even code bases like this where it's been out there for years, there's still like new bugs. but anyway, I fixed that, so it's super exciting. So basically what I was trying to do is all this new stuff with like the V2 accounts, if you're familiar with that, like the game will, whenever you spin up the game, it will connect to one of the nearby servers and like keep that connection going. Like that's the big thing with V2, is that, you know, we have like a live connection to a server at all times, so you can send stuff like both ways instantly. But the thing with that is like when you put the game into the background, then like it has to shut those connections down, and then when you bring it back, it has to like reconnect that like really quick and try to make it seamless and do the right thing. Oh no, we have a non-muter. Oh, okay, fixed. Oh no. So, anyway, yeah, so if you look at like all this stuff that's going on, like I have all this like extra logging turned on in terms of like just what the game has to do, like when you put the game in the background. Actually, I guess I have some of the logging turned off. Maybe I need to turn that back on. Or maybe it's just, oh yeah, I guess I turned some of it off. Oh no, there it is. It's the green logging stuff. So it's like every time you sign in with like the Google Play account, like mostly this logging is usually turned off, but you can kind of see like all the stuff it has to do. So it's like setting credentials, blah, blah, blah. So basically it has to like ask the Google Play library, like, hey, who am I? And then it has to like send that info up to my server, and my server then will like verify that with Google. You can see all that happening here at some point. It's like, oh yeah, credentials check passed. That basically means like I talked to Google from my server. My server said like, hey, they are who they say they are. And then eventually it comes back into the game. And then at the end, you know, that means you're signed in. So it's kind of like this long, crazy process. And it has to happen. It should be happening again. If I background the game. Oh, no. Okay, sorry. It doesn't have to do all that every time you background and foreground the game, but it has to do some stuff. So anyway, just to stop boring you, that's kind of what I've been fighting with, is like making that do the right thing, like disconnect and then reconnect and keeping all that state in sync. And the end result of that is you should, oh shoot, let's see. I want to sign in as me, one moment. All right, sign out. And, oh shoot, this is complicated because I'm using my phone as a camera, so I can't use my phone to sign in. Okay, I'll do it. Duplicate account. Use my backup test account here. and since that was screen captured, you probably were able to see that password, so I better change it quickly. That's okay. Okay, signed in as Blargfloof. Yeah, I never thought about that. Like, I mean, I shouldn't, like, even if someone steals this account, it's my email address, so I can reset it, but, like, when you're typing on mobile stuff, it always shows, the latest key. So, like, if you're entering a password on a phone and then you're, like, you're screen capturing that, like, I guess the world can just, like, see your password. That seems kind of, like, maybe not good. Anyway, so sign in with Blargfloof. Let's do it again here. So, anyway, on the newest test builds, which I have not sent out yet, it should behave like really well in terms of like if you're on devices here. If you come into devices, it should show, you know, like the game here, and then it should, if I background it, it'll immediately disconnect and see the game disappears, and then I come back in, and it should immediately reconnect, and yeah, then the game is back. So like this is the sign that like everything is healthy and working and all that. So try it one more time. Boom, disconnected, and then boom, reconnected. Okay, so like if any of you tried that on your current builds or like the test build I sent last week, I think it'll just not quite do the right thing here. It'll actually probably, like this thing will stay there, but if you try to do anything with it, it won't work. So this new one should be working totally well. And again, I know this is like dry, boring account stuff, but it's like kind of a very foundational thing. So where like, want this part to be like working super well and super cleanly, because then we have to build all this stuff on top of it in terms of like the squad system and all the stuff that's coming up. So we need to make sure that like the foundation is very solid. All right. So anyway, that's what I've been working on. There's a few other things. Like I have a little like list of my a list for myself that I've been wanting to finish up. Yeah, like I still have a few of them outstanding before I put out like a new Android test build with all this V2 stuff. And I was hoping to have that again by today, but it's not quite ready. So I will try to get that as soon as possible, but I didn't want to like rush it. There's a few things like people have noticed, like if you're signed in with a particular Google Play account, I'll go ahead and sign out. So like you sign in with Google Play, this puts you in with your normal, you know, whatever, like EFRO testing is my Google Play account. So it gets clipped to EFRO testing. But some people might have multiple Google Play accounts. Like, so if you like restart the app and then you like switch accounts, it currently will leave you signed in with the old one. So I'm in the process of getting that fixed so that if you're like switching between Google accounts, it'll do the right thing in the game and just like little things like that, just to make it feel, clean and, you know, like it's, like it's all working correctly. So as soon as I finish those few little things, then I'll get another test build out, and then we can test that a little bit more, and then can finally do this release, and then we'll finally have like V2 accounts for everyone, which is great. And a quick thing I should mention, I posted this on the server, but if anyone has been playing with this, like the Google Play accounts, I had to reset them last night, which means basically everyone lost. If you had signed in before yesterday, like everyone lost their tag. So just like sign in again and it should like reserve the same tag for you. I shouldn't have to ever reset them again. I just like there was a technical reason why it was a lot easier for me to just like wipe the data and start over versus like migrating the few testers like data to the new format. So anyway. Oh, everyone's leaving. Why is everyone leaving? I haven't been paying attention to chat. Okay, so anyway, that's the dry kind of dev updates. Yes, so yeah, Google Play logins in progress. So, all right, enough from me. Let's close all this stuff down. So, questions, thoughts, anyone? Anyone have anything you want to see? Demos, etc. Oh, so many questions. Or question marks, I should say. I was speaking, I can show you, As I mentioned, I have my, so here's my Android test, like Nexus 6 that I use, you know, usually pretty often. But I should show you over the years, like here is my my giant collection of like random old Android phones and just like test devices. A lot of these are actually too, like a lot of those are actually too old to run the game now, but I've kind of like accumulated them over the years. It's funny, there's a lot of cases where like the game that has a bug or something that only shows up on like one particular type of device, and so I would like go and try to find an old used one on eBay or something like that. So I've accumulated lots of crappy old Android devices. Oh, what is this? Oh, the what is this button? Yes, I should mention that. So I was gonna put that on there like temporarily. Do I still have? No, I don't. Bring this back up again. So some people were asking like what, like where did my Google Play account go, or my Google Play icon, and what is this V2 thing? And so I just put this kind of temporary little explanation there. So you can tap on that and it'll take you to a page that just kind of tells you briefly what V2 accounts are for and like, whoops, and like what that icon means. And this might be like a very temporary thing where maybe it only shows up the first few times you launch or something like that. But I just wanted to kind of, I wanted to protect against, you know, all these people switching their Google Play accounts over to V2 accounts automatically and then being like, something broke and sending me an email, you know? So hoping to kind of head that off at the pass, as they say. And then other things I still need to do is, I know I mentioned this before, but you know, for V2 accounts, you'll probably be linking them through like the account management page, like the web page, and not through here. So if you're playing with the test build, I would discourage you from using this linking on your V2 accounts, because it'll work better if you do it here, but that's not quite there yet. So that'll be coming soon. And I know we in the chat we were talking about like what the difference is and like what that means, and it kind of like hurts, it makes your head explode trying to understand it. But it's basically when you link here, you are only linking V1 accounts, and when you sign in with a V2 account, you're signed in with a V2 account and a V1 account at the same time. And so signing with a V2 account automatically signs you in with a certain V1 account. But linking accounts will only work basically on the V1 side. So if we link on the V2 side, then it links everything and you have like all of your data on the V2 side and the V1 side, but it won't if you do it here. So it's confusing. I can explain it more, but I'll try to just make it so people can't, at some point I'll disable this stuff so people can't do the wrong thing for V2 accounts. The story of how he loses his eye sockets. So that's that. So that's, those are a few of the other things on the to-do list is, you know, like getting rid of this linked stuff. I just want to make it so like not too many people like mess up their accounts or, you know, like do V1 linking and stuff like that, where it's like they'll be confused later as to like why they have two sets of like V2 account data, but only one shared set of V1. Ever get a studio app? By a studio app, you mean like an editor or something? Or can you explain what you mean by that? Just like, you know, an app to build like scenes, or, you know, just kind of, yeah. Well, if that is what you mean, So an editor app, I mean, I do want to have more functionality like that. Like at some point, so this is Bomb Squad, of course, the game. But then when you run like Ballistica Core, it's called, you know, from the Ballistica GitHub, like right now it's exactly the same as the game. So it just comes in up into the game menu and whatever. But at some point I want Ballistica Core to be a little bit more like an editor, or like a bit more like technical, where like it'll just come into maybe like an empty space or something, and maybe there's some buttons to like, oh, this will just drop you into the Bomb Squad main menu, or maybe there'll be some sort of, you know, like scene assembler, or you know, just something where it's like there's more some technical options for you know, experimenting and putting things together, as opposed to just being nothing but like the exact game. So I do, yeah, hope to start to do a little bit more with like editing and you know, being able to kind of do things interactively. I know, like, I like coding for everything. I'm very happy just like doing most everything in Python, but some stuff it's fun to just be more interactive with it, especially for like placing things in space and stuff like that. It would be great to have like the best of both worlds, you know. Happy with, oh yeah, okay, Unity and Roblox have. So yeah, I mean, it would be fun to experiment, you know, like in just bringing more options into the app, or also tying that into like the cloud console in a way or something, or different ideas we can have. I mean, I don't want to, this was discussed in the chat lately, is like, I don't want to try to make something like super open-ended and like, you know, Unity-like or like a full just general purpose game engine. It's like, I still want it to kind of be geared towards making Bomb Squad type stuff, or, you know, like tabletop games with little dudes running around, like that kind of style. But still, yeah, we could, I definitely want to make it possible to do that in a little bit more of an interactive way. That's one thing I've been kind of thinking about now is, you know, moving towards like the version 2 setup with like squads and things like that. I think I've mentioned before, but that will probably be a different UI. Like this, I plan to basically keep the existing like V1 UI, like all this functionality the same. It's just like, this might be like called Bomb Squad Classic or something like that. And you know, there'll be like a different place you go to just play like the online squads games. And then, but you can come back in here and do like all the old Bomb Squad stuff with, you know, like forming ad hoc parties and replays and all this stuff. So that's kind of my plan right now. And so on that note, I want to have the game kind of support different, you know, like different, I don't know what you'd call those, but like run modes or app modes or something like that, where you can either be in, you know, like the squads mode and that kind of defines everything, or you can be in like classic mode and where everything is like as it always has been. And so then like the idea of having that like modes thing, that would also allow us to do like editor mode or, you know, assembly mode or like UI editor mode or different things like that. So, you know, I'm trying to keep that in mind. And yeah, I totally agree with you here. Python is okay as long as you don't need to wait 10 seconds to see applied changes. Yeah, it would be, I mean, even 10 seconds is better than it could be. Like there's some, you know, when I was working at Pixar and doing, you know, renders and stuff like that, there's so many cases where you'd have to like tweak a shader or something and then wait 60 seconds to see an updated render or updated render of that, or, you know, even submit it to the render farm and wait 6 hours to see what that looks like. So it's like, it can be worse. I mean, 10 seconds is not ideal, but it's not terrible. But yeah, ideally it'd be great if as much as possible, we can have stuff be as interactive as possible, like write a little Python code and see that pop up immediately. There's part of me, like, I haven't spent a ton of time. I mean, I've read a little bit, but I haven't spent a ton of time, like, looking into, like, Roblox or Unity in terms of, like, how they do things. You know, part of it's just, like, I know how I like to work, and I'm trying to make something that fits that. But there's another part of me that thinks, like, I should see what they're doing. But I also don't want to fall into the trap of, you know, just like, oh, I guess I should do things the way they do. You know, it's, I think sometimes, like, going down your own path can lead to new places. So it's, I don't know, I think there's a balance, though. It's like, you don't want to make something that is too derivative and, you know, too similar to something else, because then it doesn't, like, have any advantages. But, yeah, so places and teleport service. So, interesting. Yeah, I should look into what all that stuff is. But if anyone has any ideas in terms of, you know, I keep thinking in my head, just like, oh, it'd be great to like code some Python and just have it like automatically like reload that, and like how you would kind of interact with like defining a character or a game or something like that, like super interactively. guess I can close that. We're probably done with Android for now. All right, any other questions? Oh my gosh, we've switched to Russian and Spanish. Do you know about Blender apps? I mean, I have Blender somewhere. Yeah, here, Blender, wee. But I have not, I guess I haven't opened this particular version. Make sure it's still working. There we go, there's Blender. I have not learned Blender yet. I should do that. Like I did all the modeling and whatnot for Bomb Squad in Maya, which is very expensive. it's what I was used to and what I learned like in school way back in the day for visual effects and stuff, and what we used at Pixar for a lot of things. So I was very familiar with Maya, but it's Blender is free and Maya is quite pricey. So. And Blender is starting to get really good, so like I should familiarize myself with Blender and maybe, especially working towards the new asset system, I should, try to make that work with Blender as easily as possible. Basically for the new asset stuff, I mean, I won't go into that too much now because it's still a little bit not done, but basically, the raw data formats that it will take is just like JSON data. So it'll just like be text-based data of your models and, you know, your vertices and things like that. So we'll just need to come up with something that exports from Blender into that, or converts from, you know, any of the standard, somewhat standard 3D formats into that. Okay, yeah, you mentioned here, so yeah, it'll be something different. I do, in general, yeah, my motivation is I just want to have some way where different, like, experiences can be kind of separated out cleanly, you know, where it's like, oh, if I'm going to run in classic mode, then it will allow people to connect to the game, and it will, like, behave in a certain way, but if I'm going to switch to squads mode, then it, you know, it doesn't allow random people to connect. I have to, like, go through the squad for all communication and just kind of a way to keep that stuff organized. Bob files, they will not be deprecated. So the way the asset system works is like you will supply source files, like basically PNGs or JPEGs, and then like JSON probably to define the model. But probably just very minimal, very easy to read JSON. As opposed to Bob files, which are, kind of custom binary. but the back end, like in the cloud asset build system, it will generate basically what there is now. So, you know, there'll be like KTX textures and probably like Bob files for the meshes and things like that. And so, you know, if you still want to like hack the game at a low level, you can still probably generate your own Bob files and replace the Bob files with yours or whatever. But most people, the goal is that most people's interaction with assets will just be like supplying the source files. So just like, hey, make a PNG or a Photoshop file and, you know, drag that into the window and then hit build and then it's like in your game. So the one big thing with assets that, you know, the benefit of using like the cloud-based build system is that you won't have to worry about different formats. Oh my God. Oh no, this is that is awesome, but yeah, the benefit of the cloud-based stuff is like you won't, like right now if you want to build a mod with assets on Windows, like you have to do, you know, like DTX format textures, and then if you want to do it on Android, it's ETC3 format. So it's like all these like weird different formats like per architecture, and like you shouldn't have to worry about that anymore. Like that'll just happen automatically. Like the game will, the Android version will download the ETC versions, and then the PC version will download the DTX, you know, the DX versions, whatever they're called. So Bob files will still exist, but you probably won't need to interact with them. And they may, like, Bob files may evolve over time, because the reason, the whole thing with Bob files, like, it's basically like as simple a format as possible. It was just like dumping the exact data that I needed into like a binary file, and then the game just opens it and like reads it, and it's really simple. It's, you know, we don't want the game to be spending a ton of time like decompressing a file, or, you know, like analyzing it, or like having all these options that can slow things down and having to like convert the format and stuff. So the whole point of a file like Bob is just like, hey, this is basically exactly what the game needs. It can just load it right into memory, or, you know, be very fast with it. So yeah, it's, but that's the point is like, that'll be like what the game directly uses, and that'll be what it gets from the cloud. But like, that's not the best format for like people to work with. You know, like when people are submitting stuff, you want something that's like easy to understand and open up and look at and read. And so that'll just be, you know, like I said, I'm thinking probably just like a JSON file where it's literally just like a list of like, here's my vertices and here's my indexes. And, you know, the exact like minimal data that a mesh needs. And it should be really easy to write that from Blender or from Maya or anything like that. We can come up with like an official converter or something like that, or an exporter or something. I know people have been passing around like some ancient Blender plugin that exports Bob files, and hopefully we won't need as much like scary ancient lore. So that's that. So are you all watching the World Cup, I'm guessing? I still love this animation with the that's awesome. So anyway, yeah, that's so I'm about out of stuff to chat about for this week. I will just be, yeah, finishing up the Google Play version, hopefully soon. I know that's kind of taken longer than it should have, but again, it's like foundational stuff, and so I want to get it right, and because it'll be in there for years. And but yeah, aside from that, just getting excited for Thanksgiving. Here, I found this. So yeah, big thing in the U.S. Just go eat a bunch of turkey and mashed potatoes, and then sit around for like a day. So very exciting. Ever be a mini tournament? What do you mean by a mini tournament? Can you explain? Like as part of the game, or like something that people organize? I should say I definitely want the squad system to be able to do stuff like that very easily. Like, just organize a tournament that you just join in the UI, and it's like 30 people and everyone gets matched, and then, you know, the last one surviving wins something nice or something. Like, I'd love it to be easy to do stuff like that. I need to play Fall Guys too. Is Fall Guys the sort of thing like where there's like a bajillion people at first, and then it get like whittles you down to like one or two? What's that? Like, that style of game was like all the rage for basically, like, you know, Fortnite popularized the what's the name of that? Like the, oh, three rounds. Oh, interesting. Okay. Yeah, I should try that too, just to, I know I'm familiar with Fall Guys. I've seen a lot of screenshots and stuff, but I haven't played, so I should play. That's another one of those cases where it's like, I think I'd probably be able, I'd learn some stuff from it, but it's like, I also, part of me doesn't want to get like, you know, doesn't want to like it too much and then like start copying it or something like that. But yeah, I was thinking about that general type thing. So like when all the Fortnite type stuff where, you know, you get 100 people in one game and it slowly whittles down to like one or, you know, a few people. Like, I feel like that stuff is super exciting for the few people left. Like, I like that dynamic. But yeah, there's like, if everyone is still in the game watching or something like that, then yeah, that's a bummer too. So So it'd be fun to, I mean, I don't think Bomb Squad would work for having literally 100 people in the same game, but, you know, having like a tournament or something where it's like small groups of people, you know, like if there were like 100 people in the tournament and small groups like faced off, and then the winners of those faced off, and then, you know, it came down to having like two teams fight for the championship. Like that would be, like that's the kind of stuff I'm really excited for with like cloud game, or, you know, the squads and cloud game stuff, is being able to kind of experiment with things like that. But yeah, that's interesting. So three rounds, so you don't get bored. So does everyone, so in Fall Guys, does everyone just like hang out for the whole game then? It's not like you join a new game immediately once you're eliminated. Oh, okay. So it's optional then. I guess, yeah, I guess it should be. I mean, you can't force someone to hang out. Okay. But yeah, in general, like that kind of play style where it's like joining like a quick game against, like getting quickly matched against some other people and then playing them. And then if you lose, like you hop into another quick game. So, you know, I like that whole kind of idea, just being able to support stuff like that. Like that's what the squad stuff is all about, really, is. And hopefully there's enough people to, that'll be, I know I mentioned this before, but that'll be fun to code, like the logic to try to do matchmaking, like see how that works. I always, you know, pull up my little map here. I should add numbers on this, like just to see how many people there are, like where. Oh no, I am. I'm not signed in as me. Oh, there we go. Okay. One second. I have Janky two-factor turned on. Need to check my email. Yes, I want to sign in. It's a good live test of my two-factor stuff. Hooray! Okay. So now I've got my admin account back. But yeah, I'm always like keeping an eye on, you know, who's playing at any given time. I guess it's midday, so it's the busiest part is probably in Europe at the moment. But yeah, I'm wondering, like, I know each of these dots can represent like any number of people. Like a dot represents basically a city or a town or something. So it's like, I don't know how many people are in like some of these dots, but it'll be interesting to see like if there's enough people to be able to like match them in a good way. I guess as long as like a decent percentage of these people play like the online stuff, then I think we probably have a good chance. Oh, submarines. Yeah, we need to look for submarines. Aha! We got two submarines at the moment. Not too many. Oh, there's one over here, south of Japan. Yeah, there's none out here though. There's usually the Great Pacific submarine, but shucks. But yeah, for matchmaking, that'll be fun. It seems like a lot of games, or at least some that I've played, like if you don't get matched within a certain amount, it like puts you in a game against the computer or something. So like maybe that would be smart to do, because there's probably some people like way in the middle of nowhere who either you're never gonna like get matched, or you're gonna have like terrible lag because the people, there's no one like near you. So like for those cases, like I guess we'd want to just put people into like a match against bots or something. And yeah, they probably are very small islands, unfortunately. These are probably not submarines. But it's interesting just to see like that many people, if these are accurate, like there's that many people just like living on islands, like playing games. I mean, I guess, you know, if you live on an island, what else are you gonna do? I guess playing games is probably natural. Submarine thing is actually true. We should totally just go with this. We should, yeah, just like have. Like, it should detect if you're here and then, like, give you a special icon in the game, like a submarine. Which, speaking of that, that's going back to that for just a brief moment, is. Like part of that explanation for the what is this is basically saying like everyone is going to be getting V2 accounts. So like all the Google Play accounts, everyone, You know, I want to try to communicate to people that like everyone's account icon is going to be looking like this, but as soon as we get everyone upgraded to V2, then we can go back to having fun account icons. Like maybe it'll be based on stuff you've unlocked or whatever, you know, we can experiment with that. But for now, this is just, it's all about like transitioning people over to V2. And I know we were talking about like having some more permanent icon, like not just saying V2, but I don't know. I kind of feel like I can't think of anything that would be like perfect. And like I said, as soon as we get people moved over to V2 anyway, like it would be fun to like experiment with other icons. So I'm not sure if it makes sense to plan something different. But what I want to do also is, also it was brought up that, you know, like device accounts, like people still using these, you know, there's some people that have like numbers that they like and they want to keep. So like Android, blah, 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 particular number, or PC. Like there's probably some people out there with like PC 150 or, you know, something like really low, and they probably want to keep that. So I'm thinking about like maybe if there's a way that I can migrate these to V2 accounts. Of course, these are way longer than like 10 characters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I mean, I guess I could allow that in this in these cases or something, or I don't know. I have to think about that a little bit, but you know, I'd prefer to have some way where local accounts like this or device accounts, like if people have an account they really, or a login they really want to keep, that they could just like migrate that to a V2 account. They would just have to, you know, set an email and a password for it. On a random note, like, so I set the, you know, I wanted to have like very strict rules for V2 names. So I just set them to be like, you can only use, you know, like the standard Latin alphabet and numbers and 10 character limit. Cause I figured that would keep things like small and readable, like in the game, since there's lots of like small characters running around. It seems like having names that are too big is kind of hurts readability. Do you guys feel like 10 characters is too few, or do you feel like the V2 names are too restrictive, or what do other games do? Any ideas on that? Like, do you think we should change any of that? Because an important thing too is like having them be unique and like very easy to know that they're unique, you know? So like I don't want to allow like different Unicode like space formats, or, you know, like different Unicode characters that look very similar to the English ones and stuff, or the Latin ones. You know, it shouldn't be possible to like spoof other names or have names that are like confusingly similar. So 14, yeah, maybe 14 we could do. Or we could leave it on 10 for now, and if it seems like, if we start to see like too many names that are just have numbers at the end and then just like are, you know, feel cramped, we could go up to 14 or 12 or something. But anyway, that's just something to keep in mind, I guess, as we go forward. But it makes me wonder, like, if we want to like preserve some of these, like these are way more than 10. One, yeah, like, so I'd have to like make exceptions for like preserved old names, but maybe that's okay. But in general, I'd love to get everyone migrated to V2 accounts like sooner rather than later. So I'm thinking, you know, if I can have like an upgrade account option for like device accounts, and then like a warning that like device accounts won't work anymore after the next few versions, you know, maybe we could kind of push everyone into V2 accounts, and then we can start, you know, taking advantage of them more. Put water in phone. Yes, it cleans out all the problems. And rice. Put rice in the phone too. And then put it in the microwave. And like, you know, it cooks the rice and the rice works better that way. Yeah, more features equals people will switch. I figure that. I don't want to like force people to switch to something, you know, that they don't have any benefit for. I mean, the modding stuff right now is a benefit, and, you know, additional security and whatever. like the bigger benefit will be like the squad system and things like that that you know will be coming at some point. But you know, I was kind of thinking that like for me it would allow me to more easily add more benefits if I don't have to like keep V1 accounts working also. So it's kind of like there's multiple aspects to it. And then I need to, there's several versions, like other versions of the game that I need to get updated, like the Oculus version and the Mac App Store version. I think both of those are still on like 1.4 point something. So, because ideally I would want it to be where like everyone everywhere at some point is forced to use V2 accounts, because then we can start. Because there's still like ways, if you're signing in with like a V1 account, like a device account or a Google Play account on an old version of the game, you know, then you can essentially like spoof somebody's name by changing your Google Play games name to that, you know. And so once we have like absolutely everyone that you come across in the game, once we know they're running a V2 account, then you'll be able to like be sure that they are who you think they are just based on their name. You know, there won't be any like workarounds where someone can spoof your name by tweaking their Google Play ID and stuff. Yeah, we can just start hacking V1 accounts and just making a mess. I shouldn't like I know V2 accounts, like the security is a lot better, but I shouldn't I don't want to like push that part of it too much, because there's still, you know, if you were a server owner, you can still write code that makes somebody look like they have a certain V2 name or something like that. So it's not like 100% unstoppable security. It's just if you are, you know, looking at something official or something that's coming from like the master server, and you see a Google or a V2 name, then you can be pretty certain that that's who you think it is. But if you're on like a private server, then like anything goes, you know. What do you think will happen if you swallow some Mentos and drink as much cola as you can on top? I feel like there has to be a number of YouTube videos that answer this question. I mean, I would assume it would involve lots of cola, like spraying from facial orifices. But I don't know. Or does it just like kill you? Does it just like go down your stomach and you explode or something? Not really explode, but there was always there was like an urban legend here where if you feed rice to birds that they explode. Did you guys have that urban legend in your countries too? Or was that just a weird US thing? Unless they really do that. Do birds really explode if you feed them rice? I've never seen any exploding birds. Oh, Costa Rica. Costa Rica. Who are they playing? That's pretty lopsided. I'm like vaguely following the World Cup. I know the U.S. played Wales yesterday or whatever in the first round, and it was a tie. And then my girlfriend's from Poland, so she was watching. Poland played, who did Poland play? Argentina or something? And that was also a tie. So I've experienced no wins or losses. Everything is just ties. Or is it called a tie in football, soccer, whatever you want to call it? It's probably called something different. Draw, maybe? There's all these, I mean, the US is weird with like sports, you know, we have like American football and stuff like that, but there's so many like terms in soccer or in football, whatever you call it, that are like different from ones we use for sports here. Like full time means like the full length of the game. But yeah, we don't, what do we say for full time? Just like, yeah, we just like, it's confusing for us sometimes. Oh, that's my girlfriend, by the way. I didn't know she was trolling. So that's Aga. Hey, if you see AACZY, that's Aga. That's my girlfriend. She's just gonna be trolling me on the server. She just I mean, she got Discord like set up and asked me how to like get to the server yesterday. I never should have told her. Troll master, yes, she can be the official troll master, just to keep talking about soccer because like it's the World Cup, everyone's following it. It's not like, I mean, I know, even some US people, like I'm not a, I don't know much about soccer, but I watched Ted Lasso. That's a good show. Aga and I watched that. Yeah, she's since we're flying out to Chicago in the afternoon, she's working from home for this morning. So she's actually like around here. So I knew I was in trouble for today. Put toothpaste in your mouth right after drinking orange juice. Well, that's just like a weird taste, right? Isn't I feel like I've experienced that where like there's certain things if you drink them like right before or after brushing your teeth, like they just taste super weird. Or does that actually like react or do something? Pain in tongue. Okay. Interesting. I gotta make a list of all this stuff to try when I feel like, hurting myself or something. There's also what was it like the cinnamon challenge or something where you're supposed to stuff a bunch of cinnamon in your mouth or like and someone actually like died from it or something or the Ritz challenge. There's something with crackers where you have to put like five you have to eat like 10 Ritz crackers or 10 certain type of crackers without like any water and it's like so impossible. So, all right. Well, on that note, I should maybe wind things up soon since we need to pack and get ready for flying and whatnot. Anybody have any other topics or things like that or strange things we can put in our mouths? Do you stream on Twitch? No. I've never streamed anywhere. I mean, this thing that we started, this is what episode 10, this like weekly chat is like the first time I've ever done anything like streaming. So it would be interesting. I mean, like we have kind of a small group here, but if that were to like grow or anything like that, I don't know if Twitch or something like that would be a better option, but this works for our little group here. How many eggs can you eat without throwing up? I feel like I wouldn't want to try that because I love eggs, and that seems like something where like if you eat enough eggs to throw up or get close, like it might like ruin your taste for eggs. So I wouldn't want to mess with that because I love eggs. That happened with my dad with apparently when my dad was very young, he loved pears. And at some point, he got his hands on like all the pears he could eat, and he just ate pears. And then eventually, he like threw up and got sick. And then ever since that day, he has hated pears. So he ruined it. So I wouldn't want to do that with eggs. I do like the submarine thing. We should totally make that like an inside joke in the game. Like Submarine Nation. So we need like we've mentioned before, like the game doesn't really have like a backstory or like a story mode or something. So we can start to kind of formulating one, and the Submarine Nation needs to be like a big part of that. Angry Birds, I used to, like the original one. Like, I haven't played any in a while. Are there any, like, new Angry Birds games? Like, the original was so much fun, like, back in 2009 or whatever. Like, it was crazy, like, just looking back, it was crazy how big that game got, you know, just starting from a mobile game. And then I remember, like, for a while, you'd be going into, like, stores, and there would just be, like, Angry Birds merchandise everywhere. It was, like, such a thing. And they even made, like, a movie or two, right? Even though I feel like that was kind of, like, after the popularity started dropping a bit. So, yes. Submarine Nation. It would actually be cool to, like, somehow tag those people that are signed in from, like, little islands and things. Just, like, give them some sort of special icon or special privileges of some sort. Then we'd have like people like flying to islands and stuff to like sign in from there and get the cool features. It'd be like Pokemon Go. Yes, we should. I'll have to get it translated to all languages, of course. Yeah, there's got to be some, yeah, what's a good day for submarines? You still have the thing you won? So you won. You got a toy bird. Do you still have it? Nice. You have to post a photo. We need evidence. I want to see your toy bird. My dad has a little like stuffed Angry Bird. Like whenever I'm at my parents' house back in Illinois, we just like throw it around. At least I think he still has it. I hope. Well, I can't today. Today I have to go to the airport, so I can't. I won't be doing too much more developing today. Nice. Pikachu and Angry Birds. You just have like one day where like the game just turns into like submarine themed, like everything is just like submarines with like no explanation, just like people are like what, and then the next day it just goes back to normal. That could make sense. Yeah, I'd be curious. Like, is there a day when submarines were invented? We're all gonna like learn so much about submarines, I feel, like looking into this. We do like some promotions with like submarine crews. See if we can actually get some submarines to play the game. It was interesting before I showed the zombie gunship stuff that I worked on with my friends, where it was all about like an AC-130, which is, like a, some an airplane that flies around with a bunch of guns in it and like, a military plane. But those guys, the original one they made, like it became very popular and they started getting photos from like people in the military, like on those planes, like playing the game. So it was a little bit trippy. So that reminded me a bit of this with the submarines. She has played before. Like we had, yeah, some big group games with some bunch of mutual friends, like local multiplayer games. She hasn't played a ton though, so I imagine that might be a little lopsided. Don't know if she's here right now to defend herself. If I like were to win too badly or something, then she'd be mad at me, and this could end poorly. Maybe we could do a co-op thing. All right, folks. Well, anyway, I should get going. Gotta go pack for the flight. Oh, you found them. Photos. Nice. Aw. That's pretty impressive getting both of those at once. What sort of game? Was that like one of those like claw games or something? Or like how did you like finger toy? That sounded dirty like when I was reading it. It's like I what? So, all right, anyway, really gotta go. You keep posting adorable Angry Birds pictures and things that are keeping me here, but yeah, gotta get to that airport. So, anyway, hopefully there'll be more cool stuff to demo next time. I know today was nothing super exciting, but gotta get this account stuff behaving well and keep chugging towards the more fun stuff. So, anyway, everyone have a good week, and I will talk to you folks next time. So, peace out.